Some breakaway barges were real cause for concern this morning along the Mon River. The barges hit four bridges, shutting them all down to traffic right as morning rush hour was kicking into high gear. Channel 4 Action News reporter Bob Mayo live now with the concern for commuters. Bob.
Yeah, we're right here by the Liberty Bridge. Take a look at these. Those two breakaway barges were part of this group of a dozen that a towboat was pushing upriver. You see that size, you see that weight, you can imagine with that sort of power out of control, the concerns when it hit against bridges that were to carry commuters in a matter of hours and minutes. These two runaway barges slammed into the Smithfield Street Bridge. The Port Authority's Panhandle Bridge was hit. So was the Liberty Bridge. A third barge sank on the Mon near the point before reaching the Fort Pitt Bridge. This all triggered early morning bridge shutdowns until PennDOT inspectors could make sure they were safe to carry commuters.
The default position from our standpoint and from the bridge owner's standpoint is we're going to stop and look. We're going to make sure that those bridges are inspected just in case.
The Coast Guard says a towboat lost control of two of 12 coal barges it was pushing upriver. One of those hit a moored sand barge, knocking it loose. We're talking about tons of force out of control, threatening critical bridges.
Mother Nature is powerful, and these rivers are powerful. And once the kind of tonnage that's in a barge gets moving, it's not easy to stop.
Hundreds of Port Authority LRT passengers had to get off here at South Hills Junction and wait, then transfer to emergency buses because the Port Authority's Panhandle Bridge was shut down until 9 a.m. What are you saying to your friend on the phone there?
It's crazy here.
How late is this making you?
Probably about a half hour.
So these barges are moored here. The one that sunk down by the point will have to be removed over the next couple of days, maybe up to a week. From here, where we are by the Liberty Bridge, down to the point, that's closed to river traffic for now. The Coast Guard hopes to open it up to controlled traffic, maybe later today, maybe within the next 48 hours. Reporting live along the Mon downtown, Bob Mayo, Channel 4 Action News.
All right, Bob. Well, plenty of you sent in your photos during the wait, like these from Jody Kellner. The lines were long, and the wait was longer. And others left comments on our Facebook page. Brandy says, the driver didn't tell anyone about the delay when they got on, only when he dropped them off at South Hills and told them they would have to wait for buses. It's cold out there. And Emily says, I stood in that line for 45 minutes. I can barely feel my toes. Join the conversation on WTAE.com. The Facebook link is at the top of our homepage.